funk it down.
Good evening and welcome to the third annual DWSU Charity Basketball Game. I'm your host, Michael Giles, here with Rose Bully, and we'd like to welcome all the fans to tonight's event. But before we get into the game, let's give a little background on why the game is being played. Rose?
Well, as you know, Michael, this is no ordinary event. This game is a benefit game for the Friends of the Rouge, a nonprofit organization committed to improving the water quality in the Rouge River. The Detroit Water and Sewerage Department, one of the first agencies to take action to improve water quality in the Rouge River, recognized that the first step was to aid the river in cleansing itself. Cleanup activities were directed at removal of debris and flow obstructions that impaired the river hydraulics and created nuisance conditions.
DWSD's Office of Program Management Assistance initiated a Rouge River cleanup program back in September of 1985. Members of the OPMA staff conducted a river reconnaissance, including the mapping and photographing of observed obstructions, including automobiles, log jams, mattresses, water heaters, dishwashers, tires, and shopping carts.
The Rouge River is a 126-mile waterway and runs through 47 communities in southeast Michigan. It winds through more than 30 miles of public parkland in Wayne County. The scheduling of additional cleanup and large obstruction removal is an ongoing effort as DWSD maintains an active role in the Rouge River Restoration Project, which again is why the game is being played tonight. The proceeds will be going to the Friends of the Rouge organization.
Well, I can't think of a better reason for fans to come out and support tonight's game.
That's true, Michael. And speaking of tonight's game, how do you feel the game is going to go?
Well, I would prefer to just go sit down, look at the game, and I'll have some comments for you about it, maybe at halftime.
Okay.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the third annual Detroit Water and Sewerage Department Friends of the Rouge Benefit Basketball Game. I have to read it because I couldn't remember it. My name is Mason from WJLB. You're supposed to cheer again and go, yeah, oh yeah, yeah, I know him.
Yay!
He's off, you're on.
I'm on, he's off, all right.
All right, now wait a minute, I got some. Tonight.
And welcome to tonight's third annual DWSD charity basketball game.
Just excited, including the amazing basketball team.
For the Friends of the Rouge River, for the restoration and cleanup of the Rouge River. And I hope the technical staff are getting a good level on us right now, because we're going to be broadcasting very shortly. Keep going. John Mason is out there from WJLB. He's about to announce the starting lineups. Let's listen to John Mason and the starting lineups.
First to introduce the All-Star Celebrity Team. Detroit City Councilman. Wearing number 13, we don't know if he's playing tonight, but he's all ready to go. Keith Butler. From Detroit's Board of Education, he is out with an injury tonight. We'll be interviewed tonight with Bill Bonds up front. Frank Hayden. Yeah, Bill Bonds will talk to him about this. Hey, yo, blue team, you're out of line again. Gee, we'll get to you. Director of Communications for the World Champion Detroit Pistons. His name is Rex, in effect, Half Nelson. Former U of D star and NBA former player. His name is Terry Doo-wop. WJBK TV2 anchor number 23, Mike Redford. WXYZ TV Sports, Dave Lou Allen. Not here, huh? Not present, absent? Write his name down. He's not here, huh? He's at work?
Yeah.
WKBD TV 50, Harry Hairston. And he's ready, boy, he's ready. This is his biggest moment here. WDIV TV 4, the Kroger basketball player who you never see his face. This is the body of the one and only Randy Henry. Also scheduled to play tonight due to an injury. We'll have to talk to Bill Fisher about it. Earl Higgins. Stand up, Earl. Where are you? Yeah, just stand up there. All right, there. Come on the floor. Yes. Woo! Substituting for former NBA standout for the Cleveland Cavaliers, Detroit Pistons, and Houston Rockets, John Mason of WJLB will be substituted tonight. Yeah, I had my stuff together. Will be substituted by midday personality with a deep voice. His name is Gerald McBride. WJLB's midday personality. Okay, now wait a minute. I've been practicing this one because I watch TV. And I know he works for the competing station, but I got it down. Wait a minute, I got to get down on my knees and say this one. Now, coaching for the yellow team, number 23, John Spider Sally. Yeah, I know, we got two more, I know. Now, you're wondering why they're sitting there, right? Number 12. You guys wearing 12? You got 12? Okay, wonderful. WJBK TV 2, Mr. Chris Edmonds. Edwards. It's Chris Edwards. You know what, fella? Hell, I mean, heck, they didn't tell me who you were.
WDIV meteorologist.
Oh, no kidding. Here's the guy you can kick in the pants when it snows and then we get 60 degrees the next day. Channel which one? Channel 4, I should know that. WDIV, Channel 4, meteorologist Paul Gross. Yo, Paul, yo! That's the yellow team.
All right.
Real good. That's pretty good. You guys are, all right. Now, ladies and gentlemen, for the DWSD All-Stars. Yo, excuse me, whoa. Ladies, gentlemen, and children, we will not be cheering for the blue team tonight. Just wanted to get that in right away. Assistant Director of the DWSD, number 34, Dave Fisher. Director of Detroit's Recreation Department, number 33, Dan Crickbaum. He paid me for his, that's why his sounded, you know. Wayne County Commissioner, number 42, Bernard Kilpatrick. He just got one of them names, Kilpatrick. All right. Wayne County Commissioner, Chairperson, number 35, Arthur Blackwell. Blackwell, hey. And these brothers, I think they got secrets. Y'all be careful over there. All right. Head of the DWSD security, number 15, Richard Mustafa. Could you imagine if I would have got that one wrong? I thought about that. WWJ reporter, number 41, Cliff Russell. Cousin of Bill. All right. From DWSD's main office, number 11, Thomas Winfrey. Also from the main office, number 32, Dennis Kirkpatrick. From the wastewater treatment plant, number 23, Doug, cousin of Jerry Rice. From the North Yard and Hubber, number 25, Ed, cousin of James Brown. Right. Number 31 from the treatment plant, Anthony Austin. Number 43 is Mike Johnson. Johnson. Executive to the mayor. I don't even know why he in here. Larry Simmons. Oh, he didn't show. Oh, okay. He ain't here. That's what I thought. All right. Number 40, he working. What they doing? Please tell me. Oh, wonderful. A&P commercial. I'm telling you that. Number 44 from the DWSD's main office, Otis Millhouse. And the All-Star Coach, Deputy Director, Mr. Benjamin. Ladies and gentlemen, the guest, go ahead, sir, you all right? The guest player for the yellow, number 11 from the Detroit Pistons, excuse me, yeah, Isaiah. He didn't show up? Oh, shit. All right. Hell, if he didn't come, we ain't gonna call him out. Now the national anthem, if he was here, the national anthem, Miss Floris Anderson.
Hello.
Oh, did I miss somebody? How come y'all didn't put him on the list? Y'all, hey, y'all ain't trying to make me look bad. Y'all didn't even stick him on the list. Ladies and gentlemen, city council member, Hollywood superstar, Mr. Gil Hill. Now, who we missing, Mr. Benjamin?
Charlie Williams, the director.
What does he do?
He's
the director. Charlie, my main man. This is like Charlie Wilson of the Gap Band. All right. Come on out here, Charlie. Man. Where's Florence? You ready? Okay, here we go with the national. Oh, we did the referees. Right, fellas? The guy that called the foul on Rodman last night. We're set. You ready? You want to stand or you want
to
hold it?
I'd like to.
Okay, I'll give you this.
Okay, thank you.
So proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave.
And there you have it, our national anthem. And we're just about ready for the tip-off of the third annual DWSD basketball game for the restoration of the Rouge River. I'm Mike Giles here with my co-host and partner, Rose Bully, and it's time to play ball. Starting lineups have already been announced by John Mason of WJLB, and we have a host of celebrities sprinkled in the audience as well as on both teams. We'll set the starting lineups for you shortly. Rose, are you anticipating a fiercely contested game tonight?
I'm anticipating a good game, Michael.
Well, I have a question for you, Rose. Do you know what a slam dunk is?
I know what a slam dunk is, Michael.
Well, if you don't, I'll show you one, if one should occur. Here's the tip-off, and we're about to start tonight's game. And the yellow team wins the tip-off. As the fans are still screaming, pass number 15 has the ball for the yellow team. He shoots, in and out, a rimmer. Rebound by the blue team, number 32. Over to Jerry Rice. They pass it around the perimeter, back to Rice. He dribbles, goes over to the side, passes off to the baseline, a jumper off the iron. Rebound, yellow team, number 21. Quickly down the court, and in. Nice play by number 33. Randy Henry from TV4. Up, foul call on number 41 shot. 24 is the guilty party on net. Rex Nelson's guilty of the offense. Out of bounds on the baseline behind the basket. Bad inbounds pass. Back to number right, number 23 Rice. He goes up. It's a swisher. Tie game 2-2 in the early moments of the game. Looked like number 11, Terry Duerod, palmed the ball there, but he got away with it. And he hits a swisher. Duerod, former University of Detroit player and former Boston Celtic. Back comes the blue team across the timeline. 43 has the ball. Get another whistle as the pass goes inside. And the foul is called on number 15. That's Gerald McBride of WJLB. He's about as guilty as Mason is tonight, trying to announce Isaiah being here. Back to live action. Number 43 goes up for the shot, and he hits a swisher. DWSD, Mike Johnson. Tie game, 4-4. Aaron shot. Rebound to Kirkpatrick of the DWSD All-Stars. Pass intercepted by number 15. Back comes the yellow team. Mike Redford has the ball, goes up for the shot. Off the iron, number 11, Duerod gets the rebound. Duerod gets it in. All right. Terry D, Back comes the blue team across the timeline. Number 43 has the ball. Mike Johnson. Inside, ball stolen away by Mike Redford of Channel 2. Passes up court to number 33. Passes off to Terry Duerod, who backs off. Off the iron. The blue team gets the rebound. 23, Rice brings it across the timeline. Passes up quickly to number 43, Mike Johnson. He's trapped. Passes back to Rice. Passes inside, number 41. Shot goes up and in for Chris Russell. Tie game, 6-6. Terry Duerod goes for a long one. Shot partially blocked. And a foul is called on the blue team. The guilty party this time is who's the guilty party? I think it's Rice, 23. Randy Henry for the yellow team at the foul line. He's shooting two. First one's up and in. We've got a full house here tonight, Rose, and I hope the fans enjoy themselves tonight for this benefit basketball game. I'm certainly enjoying myself sitting here alongside of you. As he makes the second foul shot, and the score is 8-6. Yellow team, as the blue team comes back, ball knocked out of bounds by the yellow team. Blue ball. Number 32, Kirkpatrick, to take it out for the DWSD All-Stars. Passes it in, the shot goes up and in by number 11, Tom Winfield.
You're holding number 466, White. Got a Detroit right wing finish for you. Please report to the score.
McBride goes in for the shot, misses off the iron to number 11. Back comes the blue team. Long pass down court, ball knocked out of bounds.
If you're holding number 466.
What number are you holding?
Please report to the scores table.
There's a shot as I ask my co-host a question and I think she's deserted me. Maybe she went to get a drink of water. Mike Redford brings the ball up, passes off, beautiful pass, but the shot's missed. Rebound comes down to the blue team. Back across the timeline comes number 43. Mike Johnson passes, he gets the ball back. Nice give and go. Johnson passed it off, got the ball back, scored two for the blue. Terry Duerod comes back the other way, dribbles, trapped in the corner, passes off to Mike Redford. Over the corner, back to Redford. He goes in, throws it up, off the iron. Blue rebound, but the ball is tipped. Yellow team gets the rebound. Shot goes up, off the iron again. Terry Duerod with the rebound. He fakes the man out of his shoes and scores the two.
Terry Duerod.
Blue team couldn't get the ball away.
4-0.
They didn't block out. They should have got the rebound on that. But it's early in the game. Score's tied 10-10 as Rice goes up for the shot, and he hits a deuce. 12-10, blue.
That's a three-point shot.
A three-point shot. Excuse me, 13-10. As Duerod goes up for the shot, off the iron. Blue team rebounds, but it goes out of bounds. And I think we've got a timeout on the floor.
Arthur Blackwell.
There's a stop in action as we have some substitutions being made.
Arthur just won the lottery too, ladies and gentlemen. Give Arthur a nice round of applause. He won $5 million in the lottery today.
Well, I don't know about $5 million because when I played today, it was only $2 million. And we have the councilman, number 13, Butler, checking into the lineup. Pass comes in. Shot goes up off the iron. Number 11 rebounds for the blue team. Tom Winfrey brings it up. Ball's knocked out of bounds.
For the free basketball, we have ticket number 140. White ticket, if you're holding it, we're holding your free basketball. Report to the scorers table.
Back to live action. Shot goes up by
Kirkbaum,
number 33. Rebound comes back, gets his own rebound, passes inside. Shot goes up, and it's two scored by number 41, Cliff Russell from WJLB. Terry Duerod dribbling inside in the paint, passes off to number 33. Goes up the shot, and it's blocked, and a foul is called. Number 11, the guilty party, Tom Winfrey. Two foul shots coming up.
Arthur Blacko is on the floor. Would you raise your hand, Mr. Blacko?
Brandon Henry will shoot.
Cheat, dog. We're going to get you.
Well, Rose, what do you think of tonight's action so far?
15-10.
Who's favorite?
DWSD. That's what I think of tonight's action so far.
As he misses the first foul shot, number 33, Randy Henry of TV4 to try again. 15-10 in favor of the blue DWSD All-Stars. Second shot, off the iron. Terry Duerod grabs rebound and goes right back up for a deuce. Displaying that former pro image that he displayed so often in the NBA and at the University of Detroit over on 6 Mile in Liverpool. Back to live action. Ball tip. Number 43 throws it in. Inside. Number 11 is trapped. Over in the corner. Action's out of our sight, but the shot goes up. Air ball. But number 11, Winfrey gets the rebound. Throws it in for two. 17-12, the blue team. Keith Butler, councilman, goes up for a shot. Iron. Rebound, number 33. There was a foul there, but it wasn't called. Blue team gets the ball. Kirchbaum brings it across the timeline. Number 33 passes off to number 13, who goes up for the shot, and he hits another deuce.
Mike Johnson.
Mike Johnson.
If you're holding number 236, please report to the scorers table. We'll be on free throw.
We've got a timeout here. Called by the referee. The yellow team calls a timeout. There's a stop in the action.
With
the blue team, the DWSD All-Stars 19. And the yellow team, the Celebrity All-Stars 12. Well, now that the ice is broken, Rose, I guess the coaching strategies will now come into play as they call their first timeout. And it seems that the defensive intensity is starting to turn up just a bit.
I didn't get a chance to talk to any of the players before the game on the Celebrity team. For the DWSD All-Star team, their coach, Benny Benjamin, he's coached basketball before. Talked with him last year, and he's done quite a bit of coaching. Did you get a chance to talk with any of the Celebrity teams to find out how their coaching is?
No, I didn't get a chance to talk to anyone, but I understand that Gil Hill is assisting
coach
Benny Benjamin this year. And as you know, Gil Hill is one of the stars of, what were the Eddie Murphy movies?
I believe it was Beverly Hills,
something
Cop.
Or other. Yes,
right,
yes,
Cop,
yes. Not Bloomfield Hills. Yeah, one and two. Back to live action. Duerod goes up for the shot. Ah, off the iron. Blue team gets the rebound. Across the timeline to come in quickly. Defensive pressure. Almost lost it. Kirchbaum gets the ball, but he traveled. And he didn't even have a suitcase. Yellow team gets the ball. Redford inbounds to number 15, Gerald McBride of WJLB. Shot goes up by 33, Randy Henry for the deuce. Blue team coming back across the timeline very quickly. Number 35, Blackwell has the ball, passes off to Kirchbaum, back to Blackwell. He goes in.
Oh! Blackwell's down.
They call it a travel. He took a trip. He didn't pack a bag either.
15 seconds left in the first quarter. 15 seconds.
15 seconds left as Duerod has the ball. He dribbles, he spins, he fakes, he goes up for the shot. Off the iron. Blue team gets the rebound. Long pass down court and into the stands with the fans. A lovely pass, but it's the wrong sport. It's not football, it's basketball.
Russell. Has he played any professional sports before?
Who's that?
Cliff Russell.
I don't think I've heard his names in any professional ranks.
Wonder maybe if he played football.
I think he's a media person. And he might just be on our side trying to sabotage the team. Isn't he a celebrity?
Cliff Russell?
Yes.
Cliff Russell
is
a DWSD. Yes. DWSD.
Well, what's he doing on our team?
On our team?
If you have ticket number 257, this is
I think there's some skullduggery going on here.
You get two free throws for $1.
We better watch this guy. At halftime, we better say a word to Benny. We're supposed to be announcers, and we're impartial. Never mind that. We're just going to announce the game, and we won't have any personal opinions. Because, after all, this is a benefit basketball game for the Friends of the Rouge and the restoration of the Rouge River.
We got a packed crowd. A lot of people
every
care about
she gets $1.
Improving the water quality of the Rouge River.
Bumblebee comes by the
do have a full house.
Right now we have a free throw contest coming up. Young lady at the free throw line. Are they giving away money tonight?
What I understand, they're giving away prizes.
If you're giving away money.
I don't think that any of them are cash prizes though, Michael.
If they're giving away money, I want a shot.
Michael, they want you to stick to announcing.
I want a shot.
And let the fans take the shot.
It doesn't have to be a basketball shot. Bring your mind to be fine. Young lady's tossed about four of them up there, and she's missed them all so far. There's our first one. Hey! She's got one there.
She got $1. Congratulations, Erica.
She's trying, though. Isn't she, Michael?
She's really trying. She's doing a great effort. And the fans give her a nice round of applause. As the players from both teams come back out onto the floor, and we're about to resume live action. The blue team, 19. The yellow team, 15. Substitutions have been made en masse. Richard Mustafa for DWSD is out there. Big center. Ball comes into Mike Redford, channel 2. Dribbles across the sideline. Passes back to Duerod. He fakes, he dribbles, he spins, he goes up. He passes off. Back to Redford. He goes up for the shot from the baseline. Off the iron. Rebound taken by the blue team. Long pass up to Dave Fisher. He drives to the basket. And the ball is knocked out of bounds. Dave Fisher lost it out of bounds. Yellow team retrieves the ball. Inbounds to Terry Duerod. He comes across the timeline. Dribbles and goes up for a long three-pointer. Off the iron. Blue team gets the rebound. Almost stolen away by the yellow team. Number 31 has the ball for the DWSD. Tony Austin passes back to Dave Fisher. He throws an errant pass out of bounds. Two turnovers in a row for the blue team. Mike Redford, TV2, dribbles, passes off Terry Duerod. He's trapped in the corner, passes back to Redford. Redford dribbles around, he's at the free throw circle, and he throws an errant pass. Back to the blue team. Three turnovers in a row. The score is still 19-15 in favor of the blue team. Nice pass inside. Mustafa goes up for the shot. He misses the shot, but he's fouled. Richard Mustafa, chief of security, DWSD, goes to the foul line for two
number
shots.
12 reporting into the game from the Spider team.
Number 15, Big Moose, first shot. A clinger off the iron. And the second shot is up and in. Blue team 20, yellow team 15. It seems that the yellow team is going to Terry Duerod exclusively every chance they get. He has the ball, fakes, goes up for the shot. And a swisher. A
deuce
for Duerod. 20-17, blue team brings it back across the timeline. Number 31 has the ball. Austin passes off the corner. He gets the ball back, goes up for the shot. And he hits it too. Nice shot.
Kirkpatrick.
Back comes the yellow team. Off to number 11, Duerod. He passes off to number 22, goes up for the shot. And he hits a nice bank shot. What's that guy's name, number 22? He's from channel 4.
Paul Gross?
Paul Gross, of course.
It's the weatherman from channel 4.
How could I mistake him for anyone else? Mustafa gets the ball, passes off to number 42.
I don't know how.
Thanks, Rose, as we have an errant pass, another turnover for the blue team. I'll ask for Mr. Gross's forgiveness after the game. Duerod with the ball again for the yellow team. Passes off, and the ball almost thrown out of bounds. Number 35 recovers. Harrison, channel 50. Number 22, Gross gets the ball, passes back to Duerod. Fakes, goes up, dribbles, goes up again. Another swisher for Terry D. Long pass to Dave Fisher over in the corner. He goes up for the shot. Off the iron. Rebounds fought for. Up. Rebound still fought for. Foul's called. Number 31 is really fighting hard for the ball. It's Tony Austin.
Number
If you ever decide to play basketball, Rose, you gotta be tough when you go up under the basket. A lot of elbows, knees, fists, bad words are set up under the basket. Back to live action. Number 42 has the ball. He goes in for the drive. He misses. Mustafa gets the tip. He misses. Rebound comes down to Duerod. He's having trouble. Fumbles the ball, and he's fouled by. Fouls on. Who's the foul on, Rose? Right now, the foul is on the buzzer.
It's on the blue team.
I know that. Yellow team, long pass down court to Harrison of Channel 50. He goes up for the shot, partially blocked, and he's fouled by number 42. Two free throws coming up for Happy Harrison. Is somebody at the door?
Let him in.
Otis Milhouse, number 44, checking in for the blue team as he gets a round of applause. First shot by Happy Harrison. Off the iron. We have a close game here. It's 22 to 21. If Harrison makes the shot, he can tie the game up. Off the iron. Duerod had the rebound, lost it. Gross gets it. Channel 4, he lost it. Ball's knocked out of bounds. Ball goes over to the blue team.
We've got a free basketball.
No, stays with the yellow team. Gross throws it inbounds. There's a fight for it up under the basket. Is it a jump ball or a foul? They've called a foul on Mustafa, number 15. Too bad. I thought it was a jump ball. So. No foul shots. Duerod inbounds to.
Foul
again before we can even get the announcements out. Mustafa again, two fouls in a row. Benny Benjamin can't be happy with that. Two foul shots coming up this time. Randy Henry, TV4, at the stripe. First shot is up and in.
Rex Nelson reporting into the game from the Detroit Pistons Foundation.
A lot of jabbering going on between the players down there at the foul line. Second foul shot is up. Bounces off the iron and goes in. The yellow team has the lead now, 23-22, as we have another whistle.
Coming up at halftime, we've got some acapella singing for you.
And an official's timeout as they set things right. Milhouse just entered the game, puts the ball in play. Gets to number 31, and he drives to the hoop and puts it up. Tony Austin. Duerod comes back for the yellow team across the timeline, but he has a high dribble. I think he's bombing the ball. They should call it traveling or something. He passes inside, but number 33, Henry, is fouled by the blue team.
Number 42, what did he do?
Number 41, Cliff Russell.
The guilty party. Spit on the opponent, kicked him in the knee. We're calling everything Kilpatrick.
Randy Henry at the strike.
Rick Mahorn replacing
Sunez. And the first foul shot.
He's out of here.
It's off the iron.
Wow.
I don't understand that.
Did
I miss one free throw? Because I only saw him shoot once.
I only saw him shoot once, too, Michael.
I think there was a snafu.
I think the players got a little excited.
I think the referees are not on the case, unless we're playing by different rules that I'm not accustomed to. At any rate, number 33, Randy Henry, is back at the foul stripe. Shooting another foul shot. Shots up, off the iron. This time, he gets two.
Maybe we both missed it the last time.
I don't know. We don't have instant replay, so we better pay attention. Bounces the ball, gets his rhythm. Goes up for the second shot. Ball's up and in. And we have another whistle list. The ball is thrown in.
Joe McBride goes back in the game. He doesn't know
more substitutions.
Terry Duerod and get him. We'll get a Pepsi break.
Terry Duerod's going out for a well-deserved rest. Otis Milhouse of the blue team brings it across the timeline for UWSD. Stops, passes, ball is knocked away by the yellow team. There's a fight for the ball. Otis Milhouse recovers. He dribbles back across the timeline. He's driving to the hoop, goes up, off the iron, fight for the rebound. Shot goes back up, off the iron again, and there's a foul call. Foul is called on.
We won't tolerate it.
John Mason ought to give us a hand over there because the referee's going right over to him, telling him who's a foul on. He should give us a hand. At any rate, two foul shots coming up for the blue team. Number 41, Cliff Russell at the strike. 42, excuse me. Kirkpatrick.
Ticket number 260.
First shot's off the iron. Second shot's off the iron, fight for the rebound. The yellow team gets the rebound as we have a tie game, 24-24. As number 15 drives to the basket, he lost his dribble. Milhouse for the blue team picks it up, swipes the ball, he throws the pass over in the corner, and the ball is out of bounds, and we have a foul call over there.
Ticket number 260.
I wonder, does George Brown have to stand up at the game to see what's going on?
I think he has
a better view than me?
I think he has a monitor.
He has a monitor. Oh, yeah, that would help. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Monitor. What a macho man get in here. Yeah. Score has been tied at 24 for about the last 2 or 3 minutes. A lot of fouls being called. Number 31 at the foul stripe.
Tony Austin.
First shot's up and in. 25-24, the blue team. And the second shot by Austin goes up off the iron. Fight for the rebound and another whistle and another foul. Foul called against the blue team this time.
Spiders team is doing pretty good.
So we'll come down to the other basket and the yellow team will shoot some free throws.
Who's at the foul line? Rex? You work for the world champion. Play like one.
It's number 24 at the foul line.
Number 24, Rex, that's Nelson. Rex Nelson.
Excuse me. I shouldn't say that. No, let it go! Would you
call him Sexy Rexy Wells?
Can I take the fifth?
As long as it's really mine, then you invite me over. Second shot goes up and in. 26-25 in favor of the yellow team. Milhouse passes quickly across the timeline. Down in the corner, the action's hot and heavy. Pass goes inside to Milhouse. He gets the shot blocked, out of bounds. Ball still belongs to the blue team.
Newsman who is just sick and tired of basketball players making all the money. Way to go, Redford.
Out of bounds at number 44. Milhouse tosses in bounds. Shot goes up. Off the iron. Who gets the rebound? Number 31 goes up for the shot. Here's that man again. Tony Austin,
ticket number 362.
He's going to the stripe for two more charity throws.
Pink ticket, 362. We've got a basketball.
What ticket number do you have, Rose?
4 minutes left in the game.
They didn't give me a ticket, Michael.
Did you pay to get in?
No.
Well, that's why you don't have a ticket.
I just walked in.
Oh, he just walked in. You did the same thing. I'm going to walk out, too. First shot goes up and in for Tony Austin. Crowd is rather quiet. We're going to have to do something to geek him up. As the second shot comes off the iron, fight for the rebound. Austin gets his own rebound, dribbles. Ball is stolen from him by number 24, Rex Nelson. And he loses it out of bounds. Back to the blue team. 44, Milhouse throws it in bounds. Gets the ball back. Dribbles slowly across the timeline. Passes off to number 21, Rice. He gets the ball, dribbles. He's trapped. Back to Milhouse.
Now you know
he dribbles, goes into the lane, drives, off the iron, rebound missed. And a tremendous foul. A tremendous foul. Number 42 was knocked to the deck.
The foul is on Detroit Piston Rex Nelson.
Rex Nelson picks up the foul.
Watching the pro games, you better cut that out, Rex.
Well, Rex got his money's worth on that one. Number 42 is a pretty big dude. Knocked him to the ground.
It's our own Wayne County Commissioner.
And the score is still tied.
3 minutes left.
He's a big guy. That's why he made it.
Is that why he made it? Well, he made the first free throw, 27-26 blue. And another whistle and a substitution. They have some confusion amongst the referees. Yellow team's trying to get Duerod back into the game for the last few minutes.
Harrison goes out.
Please step to the scorer's table and hit your.
They won't let Duerod in. He's going back over to the sideline, back to the bench. Illegal substitution. He can't come in now. Now he's coming back onto the court.
There's a little bit of confusion with the yellow team.
Just a little bit of confusion amongst the referees. Who are those guys? Second shot. Up and in. 28-26 blue team. Mike Redford has the ball. TV 2. Number 23 drives, passes off to Duerod. He holds the ball, starts his dribble. Passes back in the corner. Shot goes up. Off the iron. Number 41 gets the rebound. Cliff Russell. He's trapped in the corner. Throws up an errant pass. Almost stolen by Mike Redford. Ball comes across to number 43. He's trapped in the corner, but goes up for the shot. Air ball, fight for the rebound. Duerod comes away with it. Comes across the timeline quickly, passes off. Fake pass, goes up for the shot, number 33. Randy Henry, he's fouled. I wonder if the fans can hear John Mason over there.
We're gonna get Macho Man and Hulk Hogan to come out at halftime, yeah. We'll get some excitement for him then, yeah.
My partner Michael has left in. I don't know who this is sitting with me.
Yeah. You're not Elizabeth either.
Bad imitation of Red Fox.
Oh, but you're
Michael,
beautiful.
You asked earlier who the game officials
were. Back to live action, Rose. Duerod passes into Mike Redford. He goes up from the shot from foul line. Off the iron, rebound fought for. Number 41, Cliff Russell gets the ball. He comes quickly across the timeline, passes off. Shot goes in, pass goes inside. Errant pass out of bounds. And the fan can't take the basketball home for a souvenir. Back comes the yellow team with Mike Redford across the timeline. Passes off number 15, who goes up for the shot. Left-handed shooter off the iron. Duerod gets the rebound, puts it back up and in. Easy one for Terry.
If you report to the scorer's table, you can.
Duerod must have about 12 or 14 points at this point. He's the main man for the yellow team as the blue team goes up for a shot off the iron. Long pass to Duerod, who goes in for an uncontested layup.
Murray Duerod.
And the score now reads 31-28 in favor of the celebrity team. Duerod tries to steal.
Yes,
shot goes up, number 35 missed the shot. Yellow team gets the ball to Duerod over in the corner. Fakes, passes off to Redford, who passes off up under the iron. And the shot goes up and in for number 15, Gerald McBride, WJLB. Timeout by the blue team, called by number 23, Rice. Timeout blue, Benny Benjamin seems to be a little concerned over there. Because his ball handler is fumbling the ball away, right?
We're also looking for ticket holder number 149, White, and 241, White.
Is this guy number man over there or what?
He's calling the numbers for the people to go for the free throw.
Oh, I thought it was Detroit and Pittsburgh.
362 Pink. We got ticket number 362 Pink.
As I was saying, Michael, you asked earlier about the game officials. Tonight's officials are John Hardick and Don Hunt.
Only two? Oh.
Hey.
Back to live action.
There will be no special cheering.
I wonder if the fans can hear John Mason over there. He must think he's on his morning show or something.
Oh, but the fans love him, Mike.
There will be no special cheering.
You love him, Rose?
Can I take the fifth again?
As long as it's Remy. And you invite me. Back to live action. Blue team has the ball inside to number 32. Goes up. Shots blocked.
That one shot.
Terry Duerod, main man for the yellow team, has the ball again. He passes off, gets the ball back, goes up for a long three-pointer. Off the iron. Rebound contested for. Rice gets it for the blue team. He dribbles across the timeline, comes back, passes off to the fans in the stands. Once again, another turnover for the blue team.
What do you
Benny Benjamin is livid over there.
What do you think he talked to them about on that last timeout?
To stop the turnovers and take care of the basketball. Obviously, they didn't listen. Redford has the ball for the yellow team. Passes in the corner to number 21, who goes up for the shot. Air ball. Patrick for the blue team gets the ball. Passes off to Rice. He dribbles across the timeline. Dunk goes all the way in. Passes off. Shot goes over the blue team. Off the iron. Rebound fought for. Back to the blue team. Up.
and a foul is called on the yellow team.
1 minute,
number 24, Rex Nelson is the guilty party. 1 minute left. 1 minute left in the half. That's correct, Mr. Mason.
By the way, if you go to your local
team, we do play two halves. 1 minute left in the half.
Just bring your money.
Cheers. First shot goes up, bounces around a couple times, and falls through. 33-29, favor of the yellow team. Second shot off the iron. He gets his own rebound and takes it back in for two. Yellow team comes back with Doo-wop handling the ball once again. He dribbles across the timeline. He fakes one man, passes inside. Ball knocked away. Foul called. Foul is called on number 11. No? Who's number 11?
Tom Winfrey.
Okay. Back to live action. Yellow team has the ball. Rex Nelson goes up off the iron. Duerod gets the rebound. He backs off, goes up for the shot. Off the iron for him. Blue team gets a rebound, but there's a whistle and a foul.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you look closely at the Tall Guy shoes, those shoes are on sale right now at Kenny's Shoes. They're called.
I guess they call a foul on number 41.
Right now, I want to argue with
who got the rebound. They call it on Cliff Russell.
Dave, don't play that with me. I know you're a pro.
No.
Don't
ask me. They call it on the yellow team. Cliff Russell to the free throw line.
45 seconds left in the game. 45 seconds.
45 seconds left. In the half.
45 seconds and a half.
He must have heard me over there, Rose. Cliff Russell goes up for his first free throw. Shots up. Off the iron. We must be in a one-and-one situation. Redford has the ball. Comes across the timeline. Throws an iron pass. Doo-wop picks it up, and he goes up for the shot. Another swisher for Terry. A three-pointer. 36-31 in favor of the yellow. Long pass. Off the backboard by Rice. Redford gets the rebound. He comes across the timeline. Passes off in the corner to Doo-wop. He goes up for another three. Off the iron. Blue team gets the rebound. Russell passes down court. And here he goes for the easy layup.
Mike Johnson.
36-33. Redford goes up to the yellow team. Air ball. Here comes the blue team. Back the other way. Number 11 goes up for the shot. And hits it. Tom Winfrey. As the buzzer sounds at the end of the first half. And the score, the yellow team, the Celebrity All-Stars, 36. The blue team, the DWSD All-Stars, 35. A closely contested game. And I'm just about exasperated from the first half, Rose. I can't wait until the second half begins.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, for our halftime entertainment, we'd like to present to you.
I see Coach Benjamin is
from the Office of Program Management Assistance
huddling with his players over there. Did you notice that the captain, Charlie Williams, didn't play at all in the first half?
They're probably saving him for the second half.
Secret weapon.
Secret weapon.
On behalf of the mayor of the city of Detroit, Coleman Young, and the director of the
Oh, is Coleman here tonight? Oh, no, of course not. Now we're about to prepare for our halftime activities. We have raffles and basketball free throw contests. These activities are designated primarily for the children in the audience. We're glad all the fans can come out and enjoy this third annual basketball game, and each year it seems to get bigger and better.
Take a moment to give some special thanks to people who contributed this evening. First and foremost, we want to thank all the volunteers.
So how'd you like that first half, Rose?
It's a pretty exciting first half, Michael. DWSD's team seems a little loose with the ball.
A lot of turnovers, you're right. Maybe we can take a pause and get a hold of some statistics, and we can run down who the high scores were for each team.
Game. Can we have a hand for the celebrities and the players and the officials, please? Along with the volunteers, we have a lot of advertisers who donate goods, food, time, prizes that we're giving away this evening. We'd like to give a special thank to Panasonic, who's joined us this year, and we really have some spectacular prizes from them. Can we have some hands for Panasonic and Pepsi and the rest of the donators this evening? We'd also like to take a moment to thank the Detroit Police Reserves, along with the Detroit Water and Sewerage Department security officers who have donated their time to come here this evening to make sure that you're safe throughout the evening. Can we have a hand for those people, please? Come on, you can do better than that. Let's put those hands together. All right, thank you very much. We have the Detroit Cable Commission here this evening who are taping this event for us. We'd like to give them a hand because, again, they're donating their time as well. We give a hand, please? Thank you. Last but not least, there's a very special person in the crowd we'd like to give some thanks to, a person who originally came up with this idea, a person who sweats every year to make sure that this is a success, and he does everything from going and picking up the stuff to selling tickets to ordering t-shirts. Can we have a real special hand for Curtis Walker, ladies and gentlemen? Where's my book? Who just took my book? Hey, give me my book. Jeez. Somebody stole my program. Oh, my God. What we're going to have for your halftime entertainment this evening is an a cappella showdown. I'd like to introduce the two teams as soon as we get the microphone set up. Are we almost ready? That's Curtis out here serving as the microphone organizer right now. Can we have the a cappella teams come forward, please? Can we have Wayman Harrington, Willie Bennett, Arnold Shaw, Isaiah Presbury? This is a group who's known as the Fabulous Four. Where are you, gentlemen? Are we forward? Here they are, right here. And then we have a group who calls themselves Just Us, Curtis Walker, Christopher Walker, Ernest Taylor, and Zachary Crawford. If you'll be patient for just a minute, we'll be entertaining you very shortly.
What do you think about tonight's game?
Oh, I think it's wonderful.
Who do you think's gonna win?
Oh, DWSD, of course.
What's your name?
Ryan.
What do you think about tonight's game?
It's all right.
Are you having a good time?
Yeah.
Who do you think's gonna win?
The blue team.
The blue team? The blue team?
Yeah.
Hi, what's your name?
Emily Kimbrough.
Are you enjoying yourself?
I'm having a wonderful time.
So who are you rooting for?
Actually, I'm rooting for individual players, but I must say that I root for the water department because my daughter Tracy works for the water department, so I better say that.
So who do you think is the most exciting player?
Well, we're yelling for Charlie Williams at this point. He hasn't played yet. So of the ones that's playing, I like all of them. They're all exciting.
Thank you. Hi, how are you?
Just fine.
What is your name?
My name is Wally Quaid, and I'm with Rouge Rescue, site number 12.
Oh, good. What do you think about tonight's game?
It's fantastic. They came out and helped us on the Rouge cleanup last year, and they said, we never see you at the game. I said, I'll be there at the next one, and here I am.
Okay. What do you think about the players?
Pardon?
What do you think about the players?
I think they're fantastic. They're better than I expected.
Who do you think has the best offensive team?
They're so equal. I mean, I'm surprised at their equability, you know. It's fantastic that they're both even up, you know.
Well, what do you think about the a cappella showdown?
This is, it's great. It's unbelievable what this city is producing. It's really something.
Well, I'm glad you're enjoying yourself.
I am tremendously. My wife, Louise, is here with me, and I'm Wally Quaid. And we're having a fantastic time.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
All right. We want to thank you for coming out tonight.
Thank you for having me.
So how's your team doing?
Well, we're supposed to be up 2 points, but I think they cheat me, man. You know, I'm 2 points shy.
Do you think the DWSC All-Stars are giving you a hard time tonight?
They're playing good. Councilman is pretty tough. We got some big guys, so I only have 2 big guys, and I can't play them at the same time. But if I wind up playing them at the same time, I think we're going to beat them by at least 12.
Oh, so you think you're gonna win?
Oh, no question. As long as I got guys thinking about me on the foul line, when I'm sitting there calling them names, talking about their shorts and socks, we're gonna win.
Okay, well, I wanna thank you for having this interview with me.
No problem, thank you for having me.
It's good to see these old guys out here running around without dying of a heart attack.
I'm going to explain to you a little bit of how this showdown is going to work this evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's actually going to be a showdown between two a cappella teams. The group known as Just Us is going to sing first. Then we will hear from the Fabulous Four. Then we'll go back to Just Us. We'll go back and forth, and at the end, by a show of applause, we're going to determine which of the two a cappella teams is the winner of this contest. So tune in, ladies and gentlemen.
No, that's good.
Y'all ready?
Yeah. Look at here, girls, I'm telling you now, they call me Loving Man. I'll rock 'em and roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man. If you don't believe I'm all I say, come up and take my hand. And when I let you go, you'll cry. Oh yeah, he's a 60-minute man. There'll be 15 minutes of kissing, and then you holler, please don't stop.
Don't stop.
There'll be 15 minutes of teasing, and 15 minutes of pleasing. 15 minutes of blowing my top, my. If your man ain't treating you right, come up and see your dad. I'll rock 'em, roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man.
60-minute
man.
Well, they call me
Loving Dan.
I'll rock 'em, roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man.
60-minute
man.
Well, they call me
Loving Dan.
I'll rock and roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man. There'll be 15 minutes of kissing, and then you holler, please don't stop.
Don't stop.
There'll be 15 minutes of teasing, and 15 minutes of pleasing, and 15 minutes of blowing my top,
my.
If your man ain't treating you right, come up and see your dad. I'll rock 'em, roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man, oh yeah.
60-minute.
Rock 'em, roll 'em all night long. I'm a 60-minute man.
Yeah. Yeah.
And baby, 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 baby,
baby, baby, baby, baby, baby,
baby, baby, baby.
Baby, 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 baby,
baby, baby, baby, baby, baby,
baby, baby, baby, baby, baby.
You don't have to tell the little girl that you're going with someone new. I can feel his presence hardly when I'm kissing you. Don't try to tell me, little darling, to try and understand. Just put yourself in my place, girl. Go on, let me see if you can. I'm begging you.
No, don't you let it.
No, baby,
don't let him take your love from me.
And I'm asking you,
no, don't you let him.
No, baby,
don't let him take your love from me.
If you leave me for him, you'll be unfair. Just ask yourself whenever you need him, when I'm always there. I'm begging and I don't mind begging. I need you on my bending knee. Baby, baby, don't want you to groom when you stay right here with me. I'm asking you.
No, don't you let him.
No, baby.
Don't let him take your love from me.
And I'm asking you.
No, don't you let him.
No, baby.
Don't let him take your love from me.
So what if he whispers how much he loves you in your ear? Real stuff, no mind, baby, don't love you much more, my dear. My love can move mountains, how strong it is
just for you. And if you walk away into his arms, you'll break my heart in two. I'm asking you.
No, don't you let him.
No, baby.
Don't let him take your love from me.
And I'm asking you.
No, don't you let him.
No, baby.
Don't let him take your
ladies
love from me.
To my extreme right, first tenor, Mr. Wayman Harrington. Next to him is the bass man, the man holding down the bottom, Willie Bennett. Next to him is Isaiah Presbury, baritone. And yours truly, I am Arnold Shaw. Together, we are known as the Fabulous Four. And I'm asking you.
No, don't you let him.
No, baby.
Don't let him take your love from me.
I'm asking you.
No, don't you let him.
No, baby.
Don't let him take your love from me.
'Cause I need you. I really, really need you.
Buffalo Soldier, yeah. Buffalo Soldier, will you survive in this new land? Buffalo Soldier, tell me when will they call you a man? Oh. And the early 1800s, and Arizona and Mexico, came a brand new soldier, yeah. The Indians called him Buffalo. From the prison camps of slavery, yeah. Yes, the black man came to be. He was a hard-riding hero of the 10th Cavalry. Hey, two, three. You know many other soldiers. Yes, they wanted to desert. They were tired of the hatred. Yes, they were. They were so tired of the hurt. Now we're gonna take a little time to thank the Buffalo Soldier. Buffalo Soldier, listen to me, y'all. Been a long, long time. I wonder, will you survive in this land? Oh, Buffalo Soldier, please listen to me, children. And tell me when will they call you a man? Yeah. And tell me when will they call you a man? Yeah. I wanna know when. Oh,
dance with me, hold, hold. me closer, closer and closer, much closer. While the music plays, ooh, my little darling, won't you dance with me? Hold me tighter, tighter and tighter, ooh, much tighter. While the rhythm sways, ooh, put your lips to mine. While the music blends, we're no longer strangers. Now we're more than friends. So dance with me, dance with me closer, closer and closer, ooh, and maybe we'll be lovers when the music is. And whoa, and whoa, and whoa, push your lips to mine while the music blends. And we're no longer strangers. Now we're more than friends. So dance with me, dance with me closer, closer and closer. Ooh, and maybe we'll be lovers when the music is. And whoa, and whoa, and whoa,
dance with me.
And whoa, and whoa. And whoa, ooh, my little darling, won't you dance with me?
Okay, now's the time when we get the results of the showdown. What we'd like is when I mention the name of the group, please clap as loud as you can. John Mason is then John Mason is going to make the call as to who is the winner of the showdown. Could we hear first for the Fabulous Four? Let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, can we hear it now for Just Us? You think this crowd is prejudiced or something? Huh? Yeah. What do you think, John? It's your call.
Try one more time.
One more time for Fabulous Four. Okay, for Just Us.
That's because they had three songs.
And we're just about to start the second half of tonight's Benefit Basketball Game, benefiting the Friends of the Rouge River for the restoration and cleanup of the Rouge River.
This is the third annual basketball game, and each year the game gets bigger and bigger.
And better.
And better. And better.
Well, the players are coming back out on the court rows, and we'll see if any new strategies have been developed by the respective coaches, John Sally for the Celebrities and Benny Benjamin and Gil Hill for the DWSD All-Stars.
The score is tied 36-36.
As usual, a little confusion amongst the referees. They blame it on Spider this time.
If you've got flight ticket number 43, we've got a walk-in radio for you.
halftime, Rosa. I took a break myself.
At times, I went around and asked a few of the players if they would come and talk with us after the game. Things a little bit more personal, a little bit more background on them.
And what kind of response did you get?
I got an affirmative response, Michael. I even asked some players to come over and talk with you.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Did you miss me at halftime? Here we go with the start of the second half. Rice has it for the DWC All-Stars, passes it inside to number 11, who goes up for the shot. He misses off the iron. Terry Duerod grabs the rebound, comes down across the timeline. He still has the dribble, spins around, backs off, loses the ball, passes off to Mike Redford, who has his shot blocked. And a foul was called. It looked like a clean block, Rose. It looked like a clean block. At any rate, a foul was called on the shot. Mike Redford goes to the line for the Celebrity All-Stars. Tie score here, 36-36. First shot, it's up and in. As the fans disagree with the call, they thought the shot was blocked also. Second shot is up and in, 38-36, Celebrity All-Stars. Rice brings the ball across the timeline for the blue team. He passes off to number 11. Pass the ball back to Rice. He goes up the shot. Air ball. Blue team with the rebound. Up and in by Dennis Kirkpatrick. Big fella gets his first points tonight. Give and go. Shot rejected. Should have been a goaltend, but it wasn't called. Pass inside. Ball slapped out of bounds by the yellow team. Turnover for the yellow team. Rice inbounds for the blue team. 38-38, tie score. Rice gets the ball, passes inside. Hook shot. Goes up. All right, we've got a whistle, foul, shot counts. And we're going to the stripe. Cliff Russell at the line. 40-38 is our score, Rose, as Cliff Russell goes to the free throw line.
Pretty much all evening, Michael, the score has been very close.
I beg your pardon?
I wonder if I was saying pretty much all evening, the score has been very close. I wonder if DWSD can manage a good lead.
I don't think so. At the pace, that's been pretty hectic up and down, a lot of turnovers and everything, so it's not that much defense being played, so it's going to dictate a low score. Back to live action, blue team with the ball. Number 43 goes up for the shot. Rebound. Back to number 11, Tom Winfrey. He has the ball. He goes up for the shot. Up and in. Yellow team complaining to the referees about fouls not being called. Duerod goes up for the three-pointer and hits it. Terry Duerod, the big gun for the Celebrity All-Stars tonight. Back the other way. Shot goes up off the iron. Rebound comes back to Duerod. He hurries across the timeline. Stops. Three-pointer. Up and in. Two threes in a row. We've got a timeout.
First half, Michael, you asked me a little bit about why we had players on the DWSD team that worked with the department. And from what I understand, a few of the people in the city, such as Larry Simmons, he's an executive assistant to the mayor, Arthur Blackwell, as I said earlier, the Wayne County Commissioner, and Bernard Kilpatrick, also Wayne County Commissioner. These are people that still serve with the city. And so DWSD invited them to play on their team.
But then again, Keith Butler, why is he on the other team?
Well, I believe because maybe his status is a little bit more of that, it's more of a celebrity status, because that is exactly, well, just like with Frank Hayes. Frank Hayes is a private person, but with the public, he has celebrity status, and so he's playing. playing on the Celebrity All-Star team.
Oh, cut that out!
Back to line, Batcher. And the crowd seems to be getting more into it now, Rose. Listen to them.
Scores 46-42, I would imagine so, Michael.
Charlie Williams, the captain for DWSD, is into the game. He goes up for a shot. Air ball by the captain. Rebound to the yellow team, number 15, comes across the timeline. Passes off to Duerod. He dribbles, he fakes, he goes up. And he misses. Long pass down court. That's another turnover, Rose. Mike Redford inbounds to Terry Duerod, comes across the timeline. He passes the corner, ball stolen by the blue team. Pass off to Charlie Williams, who goes up. Ball comes off the iron, rebound by the blue team. Up and in.
Johnson.
Nice rebounding by the blue team that time. Terry Duerod working his show once again. Passes off, draws a defense scoring pass up. Shot goes up off the iron. Whistle and a foul.
Spider Sally is coaching for real.
Score is 46-44 in favor of the Celebrity All-Stars.
Don't forget you can get those shoes these
ones. Randy Henry of TV4 at the foul line, shooting two.
But you can get a pair like them at Kenny's.
How much?
Take your children to get Spider shoes tomorrow, will
you? John Mason in the background, getting very vocal with the crowd. As my partner observes the second free throw that goes up and in, which gives the Celebrity team a 4-point lead. Quick pass down court to the blue team. Up and in. Quick score by the blue team.
If you've got white ticket 440.
There goes Mike Griffin for TV2. He passes off, ball stolen. Long pass down court to the blue team. Number 43 goes up and in for Mike Johnson.
If you've got the white ticket,
we got a tie game once again, Rose. Redford has the ball, passes inside. Whistle on a foul. Offensive foul.
The score is tied at 48-48.
Charlie Williams. Captain for the blue team comes across town, passes off, ball goes in the corner, shot goes up by the blue team. Was it a three or a two? Two-pointer by Mike Johnson. Back the other way, Duerod, another three.
Terry shot it again.
Terry Durod's on fire tonight. But the blue team answers right back.
Cliff Russell,
52-51. Blue team. Duerod with the ball for the Celebrities. He spins, he fakes, he goes up. And in.
You all know his name by now.
Terry Duerod seems to be the only offensive player that the yellow team has, but he's getting the job done. But the blue team has a lot of players scoring for him tonight. Balanced scoring. Bryant hits another three-pointer for the Celebrity
team. 3 minutes to play the game. 3 minutes. No, it's the third quarter.
Pass inside, knocked out of bounds by the yellow team.
If you've got ticket number 50, please report to the scores table. The white ticket number 50. White ticket number 50, 5-0. Report to the scores table. We want to talk to you. 3 minutes.
3 minutes left in the third quarter. 56-55 in favor of the yellow team. Here's the man, Terry Duerod, for the Celebrities again. Air ball. Fight for the rebound. Players go to the floor. Jump ball.
Hey, get up off the floor, will you? Would you get up off the floor? You're acting like a bunch of kids. Just shoot the ball. Don't fall on the floor.
Whistles whistles and a lot of fouls, and it's slowing the action down. It's taking the crowd out of the game somewhat, bros.
The crowd has definitely quieted down.
I think somebody's taking your picture over there.
2 minutes.
Number 15, Gerald McBride. This is the first free throw.
It's 2 minutes and a couple of seconds. The coaches are debating.
Pass inside by the captain, Charlie Williams. Easy lob, easy score. Number 11, Tom Winfield. Got a whistle, and a timeout's being called.
The Spiders team has called timeout. Now, we got an argument. What's your argument? Is this high school rules?
Take a chance?
On what?
On calling the winning team.
Put your money on the table.
Give it to DWSD All-Stars. That has nothing to do with the fact that I'm employed by them.
I'll bet you a burger and a beer Monday at lunch. Just a burger then. You can drink pop.
Just a burger and water like we supply.
Back to live action.
Back to live action.
As my co-host Rose Bully is going up. Call the play.
Wait, Terry
Duerod has the ball. Down the line.
Will he
shoot?
Score?
And he misses.
Oh. Blue team, rebound.
I don't know what to call that, fumble?
No, that wasn't a fumble. Not in this game. But at any rate, there's another whistle, another foul. And the blue team goes to the foul line. Cliff Russell, shoot two.
Just so that you're not sitting over there with that grin on your face, that you know what a fumble is.
My mistake, you're taking the ball out of
bounds. I guess my jokes aren't funny.
Back him up, back him up.
You're very funny tonight, Rose. And I love it. Back to live action. Nice pass inside.
69-67.
Score is 59-57. As Duerod goes up for another three, off the iron. Blue team rebounds. Cliff Russell passes off down the sideline. Pass back to the captain, Charlie Williams. He fakes, goes up for the shot. And the captain scores for the DWSD All-Stars. Mike Redford of PV2 dribbles, passes to Duerod in the corner. He dribbles, he fakes, he goes up, passes off in the corner. Shot goes up for three, off the iron. The blue team rebounds. Number 43, Mike Johnson. Passes back to the captain, Charlie Williams, who crosses the timeline.
1 minute.
Charlie keeps his dribble. Passes inside, nice pass to number 11, Tom Winfrey, for another easy score. That's why they probably kept Charlie on the bench. He's a secret weapon for our team tonight. Or for the blue team tonight.
I think I told you that, Michael. You know, 2 years ago in the first charity game, Charlie Williams scored 19 points.
If you've got
the
lead
scorer for that team, for his team.
He was a high scorer, huh?
We got a walk with radio for him. Report to the scores team.
Well, he's going to have to score in bunches to duplicate that.
Well, you know, they're hearing the name of a three-point man, so maybe we'll see some three-pointers from him tonight.
Big ticket number 24.
Time remaining. It's number 33, Randy Henry at the line.
Walkman.
It was good.
For Walkman Radio, you've got a white ticket, 153. 153, white ticket.
White ticket, 153.
Thank you.
misses. 1 for 2.
All right, it is a 1-point game, 58-59. A 1-point
game. Charlie Williams with the ball.
Oh, it was a 5-point game. I can't go to school.
Remember one thing, Rose. You must shout over Mason. Because we gotta be heard over here. That guy's loud. There's another whistle, another foul. Who's that at the free throw line?
Charlie Williams at the free throw line.
30 seconds left in the third quarter. 30 seconds left. Ticket number 484. You got a white ticket, 484.
Crowd sounds disappointed. They might remember 2 years ago. He gets the second shot. Score is 64-58. Pass me this card. Shout over Mason.
Terry Doo-wop.
You cannot stop Terry Doo-wop.
I'm not going to try it.
30 seconds to go. The score is 64-61.
That's the end of the third quarter. With the score 66-61 in favor of the DWSD All-Stars.
I'm gonna give you a naked call. Call the police. You doing good? Hey, stay on your side of the board, buddy. We need white ticket number 484. White ticket number 484. White ticket 427.
And our technical advisors are passing us notes as we sit here during this timeout. And I'll just share this with you.
White ticket 427. White ticket 484.
You got a note that says to talk over Mason. Mason is our in-house announcer.
That's not what my note says, Rose.
What does, and I'm afraid to ask, Michael, what does your note say?
I've just been asked out after the game, that's all.
Oh no, Michael, it says Rose.
You asking me out, Rose? Oh, geez.
It's two rows. I'm being asked out.
And the house is rocking tonight for the third annual Friends of the Rouge Benefit Basketball Game. And the music is getting the crowd to rocking. And the announcers.
I really like the way the celebrities have been with the fans tonight. Notice during halftime, a lot of them were signing autographs. But we are having an autograph session after the game.
Very nice of the celebrities. Very nice.
There was a line over there for John Sally.
I'm sure.
That's a tall guy, Michael.
How about King Ticket? King Ticket number 25. We got a walk the radio.
We're about to start the fourth quarter.
King Ticket number 25.
Blue team inbounding.
White Ticket 4.
And we have Tony Austin, be inbounding for DWSD.
This, ladies and gentlemen, is the final quarter.
Score 67-61. As the ball is inbounding to Kilpatrick, back to.
The score is 61-67.
Ball goes inside and a stop and a foul's called. Foul call on Haston of Channel 50. He begs to differ with the opinion. Ball out of bounds to the blue.
John Sally can't sit on the bench.
Pass inside deep. And the blue team turn the ball over. Yellow team gets the ball. Duerod brings it across the timeline. He dribbles, he fakes, he goes left, he goes up. He traveled.
And he didn't bring a suitcase.
He didn't bring a suitcase.
Oh.
What, ladies and gentlemen, was a fun game has now become real business. Gee, I knew it would turn out to be this.
It's ego time, fourth quarter. Who wants it the most? Rebound fought for. Whistle and a foul. That's two quick fouls on the yellow team early in the fourth quarter. The score 67-61 in favor of the blue team. Tony Austin at the free throw line.
Makes both free throws to bring the score to 69-61 in favor of his team. Another foul is caught.
Let's see who that foul is on. Number 24. Rex Nelson got the foul.
Terry Duerod will go to the free throw line. He has really been working for his team tonight, Michael.
He's definitely the high scorer for his team tonight.
I wonder if we could say he's the key man. Obviously, he makes the first basket.
But I would think that him being on their team gives the yellow team an advantage, him being a former professional basketball player.
Second basket, 69-63. UWSD still holds the lead.
White ticket 594. We've got an answering machine for you. Report to the scores table.
And the action's getting hot and heavy now as the yellow team loses the ball out of bounds.
For the free basketball, we have ticket number 140. White ticket, if you're holding it, we're holding your free basketball.
Chief of Security, Richard Mustafa at the free throw line.
Rex in effect.
You have any comments to say about?
Well, I wonder if he got that headband from Wilt Chamberlain.
Ticket number 594. We've got an answering.
More about how he was playing tonight, Michael. Oh. That's what I meant. I meant a little bit about looking, how he's playing.
I was talking about the fashions, accessories.
This is a basketball game, not a fashion show.
Okay, let's see how he does with the strike.
He missed. Let's see if he can get the second basket. And he does. They're playing with the clock. It said 60-63. It's actually 70-73. 63 in favor of the blue team.
2 minutes, 40 seconds left in the game.
2 minutes, 40 seconds
six
left
minutes.
In the game.
Correction, 6 minutes.
I'm following Mason's lead, and obviously he's messing up. 6 minutes left in.
6 minutes and 40 seconds.
I well, can't talk over that, Michael.
We won't fault Mason because obviously he's not a basketball announcer.
No, actually, we all know that Mason is WJLB radio. Does a very nice job.
6 minutes, 30 seconds.
Lots of fouls and lots of whistles as the yellow team goes to the stripe. Terry Duerod. He misses. Blue team gets the rebound. Ball kicked out of bounds by the yellow team. Blue team on the offense.
White ticket, 5-9.
Long pass down to Mustafa on the baseline. And he stepped on the end line and turned the ball over. Those size 12s did it again for him. Back to live action, Mike Redford has the ball, pass in the corner. He passed inside, back to Mike Redford on the outside, goes up for a three, and hits it.
Mike Redford.
I like his name, Mike.
Where is that guy from?
Air ball by the blue team, long pass up court to Doo-wop. He dribbles, stops, goes up to the shot. Another three-pointer. Terry D. He must have about 25 or 30 points tonight. Defense is picking up. Duerod goes for the steal.
5 minutes and 30 seconds left.
We've got a timeout call by the blue team as Coach Benjamin wants to get his troops together for the final 5 minutes of the fourth quarter of this third annual benefit basketball game for the Rouge River.
The score is 68-70 in favor of the blue team. If you've got a pink card, pink ticket number 9, pink ticket number 09, you've got a Walkman radio for you. Or if you've got
been a thoroughly enjoyable evening, Rose, and I want to thank you for putting up with me for another year. And just think, you won't have to see me again like this for a whole year.
Oh, we're doing this again next year?
I am. You'll be here too. Don't believe a word of them, folks. But you said I have to put the ball in the.
The object is to, I know that.
All right, we've got the final 5 minutes.
The object is to put it in the basket.
Championship game left.
5 minutes to go.
Coaches, Mr. Benny Benjamin and Mr. John, get your shoes at Kenny's Northland or
Riff Russell has the ball. He dribbles. Passes off to number 43. He goes up for the shot. Off the iron. Yellow team with a rebound. There's that man again, Rose. Terry Duerod. What's he doing?
Bring the ball. Actually, Mike Redford is. Three-point shot from Mike Redford. WJBK TV 2 reporter.
Big Dennis McPatrick puts it in for the DWSD team, and the score is tied once again. Over and back, no whistle. Duerod maintains his dribble. Goes up for the shot. Off the iron. The blue team rebounds. Cliff Russell with the ball. He passes it off to Rice. It was down court to number 43, and there's a foul called on the play. The guilty party is number 33, Randy Henry of TV 4.
Mike Johnson at the free throw line. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left in this game. Score is tied 72. If he makes the shot, he can bring his team to the lead.
If you've got a pink ticket number 21, report to the scores table. Or if you've got a white ticket number 427, report to the scores table. Or white ticket number 484, report to the scores table.
This game has got us all excited. I think Rose has a favorite here. She's choking her ink pen.
Coach Benjamin's team up by one.
She's filled with anxiety.
This game is just as bitter and nasty as you thought it would be. All the way down to the wire.
Makes both baskets to bring the team score 2 points to hand, 74-72 DWSD All-Stars. I'm choking my pen, Michael, because I put...
You're choking your pen as the ball is stolen by DWSD, and it goes down to Cliff Russell. He goes up for the shot in the corner. Air ball, but the rebound comes down to his teammate, who puts it back up and in. That's Mike
Four
Johnson.
4 minutes left in the game. 4 minutes. Wow. No basket. This contest is just as dirty and scummy as you thought it would be. Those basketball players.
TD, Terry Duerod at the stripe, shooting two.
They go up for the rebound.
His team is down by four. First shot, it's up and in.
It's.
Wait, Terry's hitting those 3-pointers so he could bring his team back in a hurry.
Who's going to watch those uniforms after this game?
Second shot's up and in. 2-point game.
2-point game.
It's going to go down to the wire, folks, as always. Kirkpatrick has the ball for DWSD. He fakes, goes inside to drive, goes up for the shot. Whistle and a foul. And we're coming the other way.
If you've got my ticket number 484, we're looking for you. Randy Henry, A&P man, is at the line.
Oh, we didn't get the number of the individual who's guilty of the foul, but at any rate,
Coach Benjamin's Randy Henry is at the line. Two. We're in the gym, Detroit, Michigan. Oh boy, this is a big one for Randy Henry.
Who that foul was on. Oh, it doesn't matter. Randy Henry's at the line.
That's what matters now the most.
He makes the first shot,
and it's a 1-point game.
Misses it.
1-point game. 3 minutes and 45 seconds to play. 3:45 remaining in the game.
The action's hot and heavy up under the center of the basket as the DWSD All-Stars are fighting for the rebound. There's a player down, he's hurt for the celebrity team. Timeout. Number 24, Rex Nelson. Hopped up rather gingerly, going over to the bench to be attended to. The score is 78-75 in favor of the DWSD All-Stars.
What a game, ladies and gentlemen. 75-78.
Michael, ladies that I think I can do. I can play basketball.
To this, Fighter Sally's team at 75.
Well, back to live action, Rose.
Benjamin's team at 78. And oh boy, here comes Mike Redford with the ball.
Mike Redford.
Pretty.
Has the ball, passes off.
This is going to be good.
Ball goes back to Duerod on the outside. He dribbles and goes up for a three. Off the iron. Long pass down court. Easy layup. And it's now a 5-point lead for the DWSD All-Stars. As Duerod comes back quickly, passes off in the corner. Time's running down. Less than 2 minutes left in the game. McBride goes up. He's fouled.
Two minutes, 50 seconds remaining.
Number 15, Gerald McBride at the free throw line.
Gerald McBride, he's a disc jockey. Can he put the ball in the hoop? Boy, this is exciting. Gotta get the ball to Duerod. Mike Johnson's hot on the other end. What a game. Watch Clint Russell. What do you want?
He missed the first one.
Did he miss?
And the second. And they missed the rebound, and the blue team gets the rebound. They come back down. They're slowing it down.
White ticket, 4-6-3.
Long shot from the corner. Off the iron.
4-6-3.
Blue team couldn't hold the rebound. Yellow team gets it.
You get a Pistons autograph.
Over in the corner to Mike Redford. He goes inside. Fake the shot, up and in. Randy Henry. He gets the basket, and he gets to go to the free throw line to boot.
77-80. He gets two shots. One shot.
It's two one shots completed within a 1-point game.
He only gets one shot because he made the basket.
Biggest one shot. Oh boy.
This could bring him to within two.
2-point game.
Substitutions by Benny Benjamin.
It's Dennis Kilpatrick leaving the floor.
And Blackwell coming into the game.
One shot.
Randy Henry to the floor and he makes it. Despite the crowd's
mark. 2 minutes, 35 seconds left in the game. 2 minutes and 35 seconds.
Cross court pass. Number 35, Blackwell just entered the game. He passes off. Ball goes back in the corner to Rice. They got their perimeter game going. They're running the clock down.
They're gonna make it here.
Errant shot. Redford with the ball for the yellow team. He comes all the way down. And the foul is going to be called on Blackwell, who just entered the game seconds ago.
If you've got ticket number, white ticket number 243, we got a Piston autographed t-shirt and hat for you. 243, white ticket. Or a pink ticket, number 60.
80-78 as Mike Redford goes to the free throw line. Shoots with two, he misses.
Wow. Fighter Sally's threatening me, but I'll get him.
Obviously, we're not playing
60,
by.
We got an autographed Piston hat for you.
Pro rules.
Pro basketball rules.
We're playing high school rules. So,
60.
If you don't make the first free throw, you don't get a chance for the second one. So that explains
five
that.
Miles.
It's either us or they've changed the rules and we just don't know about it.
Well, no one explained them to me, so I'm just assuming. And I think I can be presumptuous at this point in the game.
TV, it looks good. Got a seat on the bench.
Blue Who's at the free throw line?
I don't know who's at the free throw line. Number 33, Randy Henry, is at the free throw line.
Who does he
line.
Work for again?
He works for TV, excuse me, Channel 4.
Channel 4.
And again, the crowd made it this time, and he didn't.
Score remains 80-78 in favor of the DWSD All-Stars. And the crowd razzes him.
It is a one-point game with 2 minutes and 15 seconds remaining.
As Mason just said, 2 minutes and 15 seconds remaining. 1 point ball game.
Air ball by the DWSD All-Stars. They better be careful with the ball. Turnovers kill them. Spider Sally's team can take the lead if they score a basket this time down the court. There's that man again, Rose.
Did he ever leave the game, Michael?
I don't think so.
Down for any minute?
Pink ticket number 393.
John Sally called
the timeout. 393. We've got an autographed Piston cap and t-shirt.
That's a
pink ticket 393. Autographed cap and t-shirt. And if you've got pink ticket number 60, we've got an autographed t-shirt.
That's because our island is going up. It's going up.
Now we're down to...
Well, a bowl of lima beans and some cornbread to fix all that up. The boy don't get enough soul
food. So, Michael, are you going to be tearing?
He's supposed
less
to be...
than 2 minutes left in the game.
2 minutes, 13
seconds remaining in the
game. Never mind that. The boy needs... 2 minutes left in the game. Are you willing to take a chance and say...
I'll take a chance. And I'll say the blue team is going to pull it out.
Thank you, Michael.
Back to live action, Rose. Mike Redford passes off back in the corner, comes back to Doo-wop. The main man, he goes up for a long three-pointer. He's hitting, he hits the shot. A three-pointer. Less than 2 minutes left in the game. And Terry Doo-wop hits a three-pointer and gets to go to the free throw line.
I'm telling you, Michael, no matter whose team you're rooting for, you got to give Terry Doo-wop credit. He has certainly carried it to the yellow team tonight.
Well, actually, Rose, I'm going to give the fans all the credit because they came out here and supported this game.
That's true, Michael. Fans are most important.
I was
speaking about the team players.
2 minutes remaining.
The blue team is down by 3 points. Three-pointer.
Don't get desperate.
No basket.
Offensive foul. The blue team turned the ball over again, Rose. Very critical at this point. Very critical.
This is it, baby. Just
so
like
critical. I believe Kurt Russell was.
Is that a friend of yours?
Is that right?
It's a friend of mine. All of these players are friends of mine as long as they bring home. Somebody's calling for Charlie Williams to come back into the game.
There's that man again at the free throw line.
All right.
I can close my eyes and just about imagine what this is going to be. Let's see. Just as I suspected, he made the first shot.
84-80. The next possession for the blue team is critical. They must score this time down the court.
Three is Royce. Terry Doo-wop. 85-80.
Yellow
team. 9 points. Clock running down.
Nice pass, shots missed, but blue team gets a rebound and fighting each other for the ball. Ball goes up, there's a fight for the ball, there's a whistle and a foul. With 30 seconds.
1 minute to play.
Never go off of what Mason says the first time, always say the second time. 1 minute to play.
I don't know if we can even use that. But we'll go with it.
I think he knows that we have to follow him tonight, and he's called two different times all night long. Let's go with the second call that he makes.
Let's go with the timeout in the action.
Coach Benjamin calling a timeout. This is the big one. 1 minute to go. White ticket number 521. White ticket number 521. We got a Mr. T-shirt cap for you. White ticket number 521.
Is that one of those rap records that they're playing in the background?
Rap is where there are people speaking. Do you hear anyone speaking? I don't hear anyone speaking.
Well, let's you and I improvise and
T-shirt.
Let's stick to announcing the game.
White ticket number 1. White ticket number 01.
I know I look that, but I ain't here to rap. I'm gonna call the game because it's really a shame. Score is 85 to 80 in favor of Spider Sally's team. Mike Johnson at the free throw line for the blue team. These free throws are critical.
He made that like it was critical. His team needs 4 more points. They still need 4 more points.
They can't foul here. Ball goes down. There's the intentional foul by Rice. It's going to come down to foul shooting the rest of the way. That's the blue team's only hope at this point.
Don't forget, on the deck.
That's the blue team's only hope at this point. It's to foul the yellow team and hope they miss their free throws.
Randy Henry misses his free throw.
Spider Sally on the sidelines looking very intense as this man goes for the first free throw. There's a miss, but Duerod gets a rebound and loses it to the blue team, and they throw it away. Another turnover.
The crowd is disappointed. That's all.
45 seconds left.
45 WSD needs 4 points to tie the game. 45 seconds left in the game.
But they fouled the wrong man. I think this guy's going to make his free throws.
Must be Terry Duerod at the line.
I'm going to leave.
You got it.
It's like some of the crowd is starting to fall out. He makes the first basket.
86-81 in favor of the celebs. I thought a celebrity was a car.
It is a car, Michael. It's also the team in the yellow.
Oh. 87-81. They need a three-pointer. They can't afford to throw the ball away. Fight for the rebound by the blue team. Blackwell passes off. Cliff Russell gets the ball in for the blue team.
30 seconds remaining in the game.
They steal the ball, goes up for another shot. Off the iron. Duerod gets the ball, rebound, and he's fouled.
30 seconds remaining in the game. 30 seconds.
Terry Duerod to the free throw line once again. Somebody said 2.5 minutes left in the game. I think it was the assistant coach for the blue team.
15 seconds remaining in the game.
He's left in the game call for Mason. Should we go with it?
No, we won't go with Mason.
15 seconds remaining in the game.
I'm going to go with...
Dang it, with you the power.
I'm going to go with Gil Hill.
Gil Hill yelling 2 minutes?
2.5. As Duerod makes the
Spider
first free throw.
Says it doesn't matter, Duerod or Duquan, he's got the star guard on his side.
That'll just about wrap it up for the yellow team.
And we're getting down. This is it.
5 seconds left. As the blue team hits a three.
3-point shot.
That's the buzzer, and the game's over. 86-83. The Celebrity All-Stars win this third annual Benefit Basketball Game. As the players come out and shake hands, very
tightly fought contest.
I'll leave you now, Michael, and go try and grab some of the players, see if we can get some post-game interviews.
Sounds like a good idea. I'll join you later.
I'm standing here now with Rex Nelson. He's the director of communications with the Detroit Pistons. Great game tonight. How do you feel about the game?
Well, you know, I feel pretty good. I'm not sure Coach Sally really used the bench as well as he could have, but, you know, it's always good to get out here in these charity games, have a little fun, and still come away with the W.
Okay, you understand what the background of the game is, that it's for the River Rouge Restoration Project. How do you feel about the proceeds going to this charitable organization?
Well, I think it's great. As a matter of fact, we participated heavily. We donated a lot of items and helped Panasonic come on board, because, you know, we're preparing ourselves for the future, and if we don't take care of our waterways, you know, what are our kids going to have to drink and swim in 20 years from now?
That's true. It's a good game, and it goes to a good cause. But let's talk more about tonight's game. How do you feel you did tonight?
Well, now, I think I did pretty good. I tried to play defense and box out the big guys, and as you know, there were some big guys out there. I got on the scoreboard, so selfishly, I'm happy about that. My family, on the other hand, thinks I should score 30 points, so we're going to talk to Coach Sally about that next time and see what we can do about that.
We invite you back next year. Will you come?
Certainly. Certainly. Are you inviting me, Rose? I mean, say it on camera. Are you inviting me back?
Actually, I don't have the authority to do that. However, if the person that does have the authority wants you back, will you come?
Yes.
I want that on camera.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
You don't have to call my agent. I'm easy.
You heard that from Rex Nelson, Director of Communications from the Pistons organization. Thank you, Rex.
Thank you.
I'm standing here with the Director of the Water Department, Mr. Charlie Williams, who this particular year happens to be on the losing end, but not because of a great effort wasn't put forth. Charlie, what are your thoughts on the game?
Well, it was a great game. It came down to the last 15 seconds, in fact. We lost. We fought hard. We had a lot of ball players, and we wanted to really give everybody a chance to play. And certainly when you do that, sometimes you don't play your best players. But that's no excuse. They beat us fair and square, and we couldn't do too much with Terry Duerod.
Well, I noticed that you weren't inserted into the game until the second half. Was there any particular reason for that?
No, I just felt that I wanted to get, well, the coach wanted to get most of the players in the game so that people wouldn't think I was pulling rank just because I was the director, and so I decided to go in the third quarter.
Well, you're certainly right about Terry Duerod, and he lit the scoreboard up tonight.
Yes, he, as I understand it, he had over 50 points.
50?
And 7 three-pointers.
Well, we weren't counting, but it seems like he was their main offensive weapon.
Well, he was the main man, just as he was in high school and also his college and pro career. He's a magnificent ball player, tremendous shooter.
Well, I know the fans had a tremendous time here, and I certainly enjoyed myself. And looking forward to another benefit game next year.
Yeah, we're excited about the results of our first three campaigns. I think this is the biggest ever. And it'll be difficult to improve on it, but we're going to try to improve. I really enjoyed the halftime sing-off between the two a cappella groups. And just everybody had a lot of fun, real attractive T-shirts, all the prizes, the Pistons donated, Sony, everybody. It's just a great, 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 great affair.
We're getting bigger and better, and I'm looking forward to it again.
Yeah, we are too. Thank you.
Thank you for stopping by.
No problem.
I know you want to get down and change and everything.
Yeah.
And we'll see you next year.
All right.
I'm standing here with Mike Redford of TV2 News. He's a reporter and an anchorman on Channel 2. Mike, 86-83. How do you feel about tonight's game?
Well, we won. That's nice. We were sweating little bullets there the last couple of minutes. A lot more physical than I thought it would be. Those guys from Water and Sewer play pretty rough, but overall, a lot of fun. John Selle, our coach, made it interesting. It was a real treat to play, and I enjoyed playing.
That's good. Mike, tell me a little bit about how you prepared for tonight's game. I know in the past 2 years, we have played against Channel 2 in our charity game. This year, we decided to go a little bit different and play with a celebrity all-star team. Mike, why did you come back?
Why did I come back? Well, first of all, I'm a native Detroiter, and I love the city. And anytime I get a chance to help a city event, particularly the Friends of the Rouge, the benefit, I get a chance to go out and play. And again, I play with these guys the last couple of years, the water and sewer guys. They're always a lot of fun to play with. They've invited me back, and it's a real treat for me to come on back. I'll come back next year.
Okay. Did you do any preparations for tonight's game, any workouts or exercising?
Well, let me tell you, up to about a year ago, I was working out quite a bit and playing a lot of basketball, doing a lot of running. But I've got an 18-month-old son who doesn't let me go out and run around the neighborhood without him. So I chase him up and down the living room. That's where I get my workouts lately, quite frankly.
That's good, Mike. You played a good game tonight. Congratulations, and we'll hope to have you back next year.
I sure be back. Nice being here.
I'm standing here with Cliff Russell. He played on the DWSD All-Star team. And I have a question that I want to ask you, Cliff. Why were you on the blue team as opposed to the celebrity team, you being a celebrity yourself?
Well, I'm not sure whether or not there was enough room for me on the media team or whether or not Charlie wanted me to help out on the water team. But I was pleased to be on the blue team. I wish we could have put forward a better effort than we did.
Well, you certainly did your part tonight.
Well, it's a team game, and you know, I played hard. I think we all ran out of gas there in the end. But next year we'll get them.
Well, I'm glad you came this year, and we look forward to seeing you again next year. I certainly enjoyed myself, and all the fans had a tremendous time.
It was a pleasure. It was a pleasure being here. It was for a worthy cause. It's nothing like good fun with good people for a good cause.
Was this your first time playing for us?
My first time playing for you. I certainly hope it won't be my last, but it's a fantastic benefit, fantastic effort. I enjoyed it.
You think Charlie's going to have you back again next year?
I don't know. I missed a few shots at the end there. He might think about it. But
but you made enough of them to keep him in the game, though.
Hopefully that'll redeem me. He'll bring me back next year.
Well, thanks, Cliff, for stopping by. I know you want to get out of here. It's Saturday night in Detroit. Motown waits.
Yep. Let's get out. Pleasure being here.
My pleasure, sir.
Thank you. Take care, Mike.
I'm standing here with a very big guy, Harry Hairston, Channel 50. Harry, what do you do with Channel 50?
Mostly crime reporting and backup anchoring for our 10 o'clock news.
That has nothing to do with actually playing basketball. How did you prepare for tonight's game?
Well, I tell you, I got up real early this morning, looked at the clock, then I went back to bed, slept a while. Then about noon, got up, had a couple beers, and went to the Y, took a sauna, had another brewski there, played a little ball this afternoon, and kind of like got in just before the game started, and I really felt pumped about it.
Yeah, well, your team did well. I don't believe that was your schedule, but that's okay. Your team did well, 86-83. How do you feel about that?
Well, naturally, we were supposed to win with a coach like John Sally. You really can't go wrong. We came in here knowing that we were the good guys, and the good guys always win in the end. So although it was close, we knew that was going to happen.
I'm sure that you know the background on why the game is being played for the Friends of the Rouge organization.
Yes, and I'm really glad to be a part of something like this because, you know, it's necessary, it's good for the community, and I hope to be a part of this again.
Okay, so then if the Detroit Water and Sewerage Department All-Star team invites you back to play next year, you will be here.
Oh, more than happy to come back next year.
Okay, well, thanks for coming tonight, and Okay. Congratulations.
Thank you. Okay, take care.
We're standing here with Otis Milhouse, one of the DWSD All-Stars. And Otis, give us your reflections on tonight's third annual benefit basketball game.
Well, I think the game was pretty well played by both teams. We kind of lost it in the end, but we lost it to a real good team. Duerod hit about 50 points, and that kind of hurt us a lot. But all in all, I think we did pretty good.
Well, next year, maybe this fella can play for your team.
Well, I'm working on getting him into shape, but he'll have a couple of years yet.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll look forward to next year's game.
Well, thank you. I had a nice time.
Paul Gross, Channel 4 meteorologist. I'm standing here talking with your team, 86-83. Congratulations.
Well, thank you very much. You know, I'm not a great offensive player. I'm out there. John put me out there just for defensive purposes, and I think that's why he put me out in the final 3 minutes there when the game was close, because I certainly don't score many points. I only had 2 points tonight. But there are other contributions you can make on the floor, sure.
That's true. That's true. The game tonight is being played for the benefit of the Friends of the Rouge organization. As a scientist, I'm sure that you can appreciate what this organization is about.
Absolutely. You know, we all live in the same world, and you know, if you pollute a river, say in one city, that's going to affect not only some of the people in that city, but that's going to affect people downstream in that river. And so the whole organization is there to clean up the Rouge. The Rouge used to be a beautiful, clean river, and now we have to clean it up, and a lot of people are pitching in. It's a lot of great effort in the Rouge. We're seeing improvements year after year, and we just got to keep doing it. And I think eventually we're going to have a good, clean Rouge River and something everybody can enjoy.
So actually, because it will take some time to actually clean up the Rouge River, we could expect that this game will be played again next year.
I would certainly hope so. I understand this is the third annual game, and it was very well organized. All of us here in the media were treated very, very well. We had a great time. It was very well organized, and we'd all love dearly to be back here next year.
Okay, well, we'll keep that in mind for next year's game. I'm sure that the department will continue its efforts in improving or taking actions to improve the Rouge River.
And they have a pretty good basketball team, too.
Pretty good. Your team was pretty good, too. In fact,
yeah,
your team won, so.
But they pushed us to the limit. Don't take any credit away from them.
It was a good game. It was a good game tonight and for an excellent cause, and we'd like to have you back next year.
Thank you. Great game for a great cause. Sure.
Funky down.
Shake your mind. I'll do what you want to do. I can't tell you how to catch a groove. Do what you wanna do. I won't tell you what side to choose.
We was on a dance floor shaking our thing to a funky beat with a go-go swing. Everyone was watching, they did it shot. Amazed at how salt and pepper was rock. In the place with a smile on our face. Some got upset and then tried to bait. They called us nasty, said we did dirty. Crew, we were freaks, cheap, even flirty. Pepper got picked and pulled out of pump. I was all set not to jib but to jump. Spin broke it up and asked not to break. Said they don't understand the way you
take your mind. How do what you wanna do? I can't tell you how to catch a groove. It's your fine thing. Do what you wanna do. I won't tell you what it's like to do.
Shake that thing, come on, y'all.
Shake it,
we could get loose,
but we can't get naked.
It's not a crime, it's legal, we can't sit. Look again, see, we're just dancing.
Relax a bit, now ain't that better?
I think it's time for you to get our partner. Do-see, gathering, no sleep. I wanna see the ones that most front on a cutie. Hope you're not fruity. Do your duty and
shake your thing.
Ow,
do what you wanna do. I can't tell you how to catch a groove. It's your fine thing. Do what you wanna do. I won't tell you what it's like to do.
Come on, y'all, shake that thing. You got to just show no shame. I want you to shake that thing. Come on, y'all, show no shame.
Shake your thing, yeah, yeah.
Oh, you looking sweet, baby.
Ow.
I won't tell you how to catch a groove.
It's my thing.
I'm swinging
the way that I feel with a little seduction and some
sex appeal.
It's Friday night and I just got paid. I'm checking out the fella with the high top fade. Moving in closely,
ready for the kill.
Stepping on a dance floor.